I think in a way, some of these newer firms do have certain advantages. In particular, many of the incumbent firms are encumbered by legacy systems, often multiple legacy systems that were put in place before these cyber threats reached the state that they are now.
Anytime you have a single point of entry, or even multiple point of entries controlled by a single source, you're opening yourself up to a cyber attack. To me, that is one of the great benefits of the blockchain and the DLT, is that it's entirely decentralized, and in many of the systems, there's no central point of control. And to me, that is the best protection, diversification.
Fintechs and other types of innovative companies are coming up with new ways to communicate and visualize the risks and security solutions. When you're dealing with the senior executives in a lot of companies, including financial institutions, they are not going to understand the problem in ones and zeros. So any products and any services that can help them to grasp the scope of the problem and really understand the options available to them, I think are a huge help.
Frankly, the single greatest threat we have in terms of cyber is complacency, because we can never get ahead of the hackers that their very being is trying to find a ways around through the loopholes more quickly than we develop new solutions in that regard.
There are lots of new strategies that are now constantly being developed by startups to help combat cyber threats on many, many different levels. One of the most interesting, I think, changes or that this can drive in an organization is that a lot of these startups are founded by and the technology is developed by people who actually have experience as an attacker.
At one point, I believe that people thought fintech was great because these were people that wanted to break the banking system and had new ideas that were going to help support. And I think there's a naivete in that anyone can learn a new technology and have bad intentions, whether it be an individual and or an organization.
As these fintechs become more widely recognized, occupy more and more important spot in our financial system, they will absolutely be more of a target.
As I tell a lot of my clients, it's not that you need to prepare for a cybersecurity attack. You've already had one, and you're just not aware of it.
Criminals follow the money, and as more money gets into fintech, they are going to be after it. I think it'll also be interesting to see how criminals recognize new types of opportunities and types of attacks that can be launched against some of these fintech products and fintech companies.
The pace of innovation is so great that if you try to keep up with it by yourself, you end up spinning out of control. And so this is actually one of the areas that I'm trying to focus on today is enabling through collaboration platforms, collaboration around innovation in the cybersecurity space between financial services infrastructure and bank players.
I think that nowadays we need much more to know to whom we are talking, and much more verifying things before we engage in conversations. People are much more concerned, not only about security, but about liability, data leaks, and things like that. So actually, you see that conversations now become a lot more formal and using more secure channels.
The official sector itself needs to practice good cyber hygiene, needs to consider standards that they need to adhere to as much as possible. And that's also something that we've been hearing out of the official sector in the United States.
So I think there's plenty of opportunities to collaborate. One of the interesting things about fraud and cyber attacks is that they're very fast moving. So we have to be very fast acting. We have to find it. We need to stop it before major harm occurs.